It is time at long last to unbox the iPad mini, or as we call it around here, the unicorn. Let's check it out. I have some other tablets for comparison. The iPad mini, as you know, is a 7.9-inch tablet, $329. Ooh, iPad minis. This is a light box. I've heard people's overwhelming responses to it seem to be our reviewers saying that it is very light, really unexpectedly light. And that's kind of what I'm getting from it so far. Let's get it out of here. No time to waste. Come on, little iPad mini. Man, this box is light. This is startling, and it's with all the packaging. Okay, out you come. Wow. That is a lightweight tablet. It seems like it weighs about as much as an iPhone. Okay. Here's our packaging, in case you care. This one does come with a power brick, which is nice to see. Unless you already have a bunch of them. There's a move away from power bricks that is environmentally motivated, and in some cases I'm in favor of that, but still it's kind of useful. Lightning connector, and that's pretty much it. A little bit of instruction stuff in here, I assume. Let's get to the tablet. So it's thinner. Let's hold up the old iPad for comparison here. We'll do a screen comparison later, but here's the size difference between these two guys. Pretty distinct. It's a little bit thinner than the old iPad. It makes this thing feel like about a 60-pound brick. I mean, you feel like you can't believe you were carrying around this clunk. This is like tossable. You have kind of a nice matte black back here. Now, it is wider than some of the true 7-inch tablets. Here's a Nexus 7 by comparison. The Kindle Fire HD, of course, is about this wide. And as you know, I'm not a huge fan of this size. It makes it a little bit hard to hold. You can hold this with one hand, but after a little while, you're gonna get the dreaded 7-inch tablet hand cramp. All right, but let's turn it on. We do have some physical buttons on the side, and of course, power up here. While we wait for it to power up and do some setup, let's get to the specs. The iPad mini starts at $329 for the 16 gig Wi-Fi version, and it goes up from there. The max you could pay is $659 for the 64 gig model with LTE. The iPad mini comes in two colors, black and white, or silver slate and black slate. It is 5.3 inches wide and 0.28 inches thin. It's 7.8 inches tall and it weighs 0.68 pounds. The display is a 7.9 inch LED backlit multi-touch display. It's IPS and the resolution is a somewhat disappointing 1024 by 768. Not only is that not a Retina display, it's actually worse than both the Nexus 7 and the Kindle Fire HD. Both of those are 1280 by 800. This is also the first iPad with dual stereo speakers, so it should sound pretty good for movies and games. It has a dual-core A5 processor that's the same as the iPad 2. It obviously runs Apple iOS, and it has the new Lightning connector. There are two cameras. The front-facing FaceTime camera takes 1.2 megapixel photos and does 720p HD video. The rear camera is a 5-megapixel camera for taking photos. Battery life should be pretty good if it's anything like the original iPads. Up to 10 hours of surfing on Wi-Fi is what Apple states. So the iPad mini. Look, if you have an iPad or an iPhone with a Retina display and then you go look at this thing, it's gonna bug you. And $329 is not a lot to pay for an iPad, considering that the last ones were $500, but I don't feel like this is a great value. I think the size, the weight, and the apps are wonderful, and it's probably gonna be a great seller, but I would say that it's probably worth waiting these 6 to 8 months, no more than a year, before they release this model with a Retina display for the exact same price. You know what's gonna happen. Hold out if you can.